Hugh Hogan, back in the RDS for the first time in 5 months. It's been quite a while.
It sure has, yeah. No, definitely excited to be back in the RDS. Looking forward to the game now tomorrow night.
In Italy last weekend, it's a shorter turnaround this week. Presumably, you're a contact skills coach for Leinster Rugby. Presumably, that creates and poses all sorts of challenges for the coaching team in a shorter week.
Yeah, absolutely. I suppose you've got to be cognizant that it is 6 days, so arriving back late on Saturday night, you've got to turn the page quite quickly. After reviewing the game on Monday morning, it's very much focusing ahead and to the Ospreys for the week rather than dwelling on what happened on the weekend.
How did training go this week? I'd imagine it was difficult enough to get a dry ball all week.
It kind of was, yeah. It was actually quite nice today now, so we're hoping that can be the same tomorrow night. But I suppose if you saw the photos on the website of Monday's training, it was certainly wet and windy, but yeah, no, absolutely. It was good to turn the page quickly, get into the Ospreys and get out and train well on Monday.
Michael Milne and Harry Byrne making their debuts last week. Great for them. Hopefully tomorrow evening they'll be coming off the bench and making their home debut. But obviously Rowan Osborne in a similar boat, making potentially his full senior debut for Leinster Rugby tomorrow. Great story for Rowan. Obviously he's been playing with Trinity and the AIL and finally getting a chance with Leinster Rugby.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's brilliant, and it's testament to Rowan and the journey he's gone on. It's exciting when you see any player come through the system and have an opportunity to make their debut. But for Rowan, I suppose he played Leinster 19s in 2014, Leinster 20s in 2015, and kind of wasn't involved in the professional setup after that. So he went and played with Trinity, and he's had two brilliant seasons with them over the last couple of years. Obviously, they made the AIL semi last year for people who would have watched that. And he came in to train during the summer. He's done really well. He's shown he's up to the level and that he can add something to the game. So it's brilliant that he's taken the chance and he gets the opportunity tomorrow night, hopefully to come off the bench.
We saw that a couple of years ago as well, even in the last World Cup cycle, lads coming into Leinster Rugby, and it says a lot about the pathways as well, doesn't it, Hugh, in terms of our clubs, our schools, but obviously the AIL and the crucial role that the AIL plays in the development of these younger players.
Hugely, yeah, absolutely. I'm a big fan of the AIL myself, and I think it's so important that we do support those teams and keep our eyes on those teams, because the quality is there. And you know, just because a player mightn't get a professional opportunity at 19 or 20 doesn't mean they won't be good enough at 23, 24, 25. So it's brilliant when guys can actually show that in the club game and it translates into the professional game.